My name is Doug Parker, host of the Cruise Radio Podcast, and this is a tour of Norwegian Sky. Before we get to the ship, if you like this video and you want to see more, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. So Norwegian Sky was launched in 1999. She carries 2,004 guests, comes in at 77,104 gross registered tons, and is 832 feet long. So deck four is nothing but staterooms, so we'll start on deck five. All the way forward is where my stateroom was. Basically, if you kept walking deck five forward till you couldn't walk any further, this is where I was located. The ship was refurbished back in early 2019, and it received some enhancements, especially in the staterooms, including new bedding and those USB plugs added to the bedside lamps that make things really convenient. The bathroom is a little cramped. You'll find the plastic shower curtain like you have on most ships, but for a short cruise, it certainly wasn't horrible. My interior room was 121 square feet. Now, there are three banks of elevators on Norwegian Sky. You have the four forward elevators, you have four in the main atrium, and then four on the aft end of the ship. The closest elevator to the casino and off the main atrium would be those glass elevators located within the main atrium. Those will take you up from deck 5 to deck 12. Walking through the atrium on deck 5, you'll see the guest relations desk on your port side, then along with those four glass elevators in the middle, just opposite is going to be the shore excursions desk and the dining reservations area. There are two main dining rooms on Norwegian Sky. However, just because they are main dining rooms, it doesn't mean that they have those traditional set dining times. Norwegian Cruise Line bases their cruise vacations on freestyle cruising, so guests can basically choose where they want to eat and at what time they want to eat. I will say it's good to make a reservation first, though. The main dining rooms also are included in the price of your cruise. So let's talk about the dining rooms. The midship dining room is called the Palace Dining Room. You can access this dining room right off of the main atrium. There's also an entrance slash more of an exit on the aft part of the dining room. That'll take you up to the stairs to deck 6, or if coming out of the restaurant, you'll walk through the French venue called Le Bistro. No clue. This is a specialty venue that is a la carte. Reservations are required here. Now, the aft main dining room is called the Crossings, and this is another dining option with a little better views than the midship dining room because you have those views overlooking the ocean from back here. The access to this one is kind of weird in being that because the kitchen is between the two midship and aft dining rooms, you have to go up to deck 6 and then walk down to the restaurant. Or I guess you could walk through Le Bistro if you wanted to, but that would be kind of rude and no reason to barge through someone's meal. Starting on deck 6 aft and walking forward, the main show theater is located on both deck 6 and 7 aft. This is where you'll find the comedian. You'll also find the musical review shows in here, as well as that welcome aboard show happening on the first night. Now, the seating is decent in here. I never saw a show on the 6th floor. I was always at the top, but there really wasn't a bad view at the top. Really, there was a little bit of pole obstruction, but it wasn't horrible. If you get there early enough, you can pretty much pick where you want to sit. Now, outside of the theater on deck 6 is the photo gallery. Also within here is the Mark Twain Library and some conference rooms for the passengers that are doing seminars at sea or having conferences on board. The photo gallery has both computer terminals and binders with photos. They also sell cameras and accessories in here as well. Continuing to walk forward, you'll come to the Sugarcane Mojito Bar. This is also a new addition from the 2019 dry dock. If you've sailed on Sky before, this was previously called the Captain Cook's Bar. Another new addition is just forward called the Bliss Nightclub. You'll find Bliss on a lot of the newer Norwegian cruise ships. This spot is really multi-purpose. By day, it's used for presentations and Q&As with the officers and crew members. And then by night, it turns into a high-energy dance club. The atrium on deck 6 has a couple of computer terminals located within the internet lounge and then some seating around here as well in some shops too. I did find it interesting that this ship has a full-time internet manager. Usually this job has been deferred to the guest relations desk on a lot of cruise ships. Deck 6 forward, you'll find nothing but staterooms. Something different that this ship has is a split deck. So there's a deck 6 and then a deck 6A. Keep in mind that if you're booking a deck 6A stateroom, you will have to use the stairs because there is no elevator bank that accesses deck 6A. As a side note, if you're wondering why split decks exist, it's usually a result of higher ceilings in the public space or big machines below them that make them raise the roof a little bit. One of my favorite areas on Deck 6 is the outdoor running track because it goes the whole length of the ship. That means you could start at one place, run forward, go across the bow, all the way down the side, across the stern, and back to where you started as many times as you want. The direction of the joggers is the standard counterclockwise on the ship, but it's some really good views, too. You can't really peek out over the front of the ship, like over the bow, because it's kind of covered in that area, but you do get good stern views back there. Up to Deck 7, we'll start forward, where you'll find the Kids Club and the arcade area. Norwegian Cruise Line's Kids Club is called the Splash Academy, and that's divided by different age groups. This was a popular spot. You do have to check the daily activities, so I'd suggest, if you do have kids, to check in right when you get on board to kind of pick up a weekly schedule so you know what's going on and when it's open and things like that. Walking aft, you'll come through the atrium. This is the last real deck of the atrium with a staircase access. You can actually go from 7 to 6 to 5 with the stairs. On the other decks, you can't in this space. Here you'll find the atrium cafe and bar, and then set up in the evenings is a piano player right next to the atrium cafe and bar with a variety of tables set up. You'll also find people standing and singing along. It seemed to be a really good time. Piano bar isn't really my thing, but the folks who do enjoy it, it's there for you. Now, the casino is located midship on Deck 7 on Norwegian Sky. You'll find a variety of slot machines in here and also table games. And then at the casino bar, there are gaming devices inlaid into the counter. So if you want to drink and play at the same time, there's digital games here to play. And you can also do sports betting in here as well. The ventilation in the casino is adequate. It varies on how many smokers are in here, though. You can definitely tell it's a smoking casino. In certain times, were worse than others, but it never like stopped me in my tracks. But that, I guess, that depends on how sensitive you are to smoke because everyone's different, right? Outside of the casino, you'll find a couple of duty-free shops that offer liquor, cigarettes, and logo gear. There's also a full-service Starbucks out here on this deck. It's basically a replica of everything you'll find on a land-based Starbucks, even though seasonal drinks were being served in here. More shops are behind the Starbucks, and if you keep walking straight, that'll take you into the top deck or the second level of the main theater, or if you go down, you'll go to the Crossings restaurant down on Deck 5. Now, Decks 8, 9, and 10 are all stateroom decks, and Deck 11 is where you'll find the food, the drinks, and the pool. We'll start at the back of the ship on Deck 11. That's where you'll find the local bar and grill. This is the place that's included in the cost of your cruise, and it's a round-the-clock sports bar with items such as wings, nachos, chili, salads. They have burgers in here. You'll want to pay attention to the hours, though. It's not truly 24/7, but it's pretty much around the clock if you're an average party animal. On the back deck, there's the Great Outdoors. This is basically an extension of the inside buffet with a lot better views, though. It also has two sides here, so there's plenty of space where passengers can disperse back here on the back of Deck 11. This spot really gives you a connection to the ocean, too, because if you're sitting back here, you can just basically look out over the water. And also, the best thing about this is if it's too hot or if it's rainy, it's covered. So there's a big tent set up here, so you don't have to worry about getting wet or scorching. There's also a bar back here serving up cold drinks. Inside on Deck 11, it's the Garden Cafe. That's the buffet, and it feeds from both sides, both front and forward, but it pretty much meets in the middle where the dessert station is. Being that the ship doesn't carry that many people, it never felt overly crowded in here, and it was always easy to find a seat. There's also additional seating by the pool. There are four hot tubs on Norwegian Sky with two swimming pools on the main pool deck. There's also a bar out here with a couple of showers by the pool. This area is really jumping during the day with a DJ and live music. And then at nighttime, the entertainment staff holds all the parties out here as well, and it gets pretty wild. Now, tucked away on deck number 11 is La Cucina. This is another specialty venue that features Italian food. A little secret, if you like pizza, make sure you come here during lunch because they do serve complimentary pizza up until around 3 o'clock. A lot of people didn't even notice this, and I actually stumbled upon it on accident. So if you like pizza, La Cucina is the place to be. And if you like Italian food, make reservations here. Inside on deck 11, you'll find the Mandara Spa, which I did not get to access, but there are your basic treatment massage rooms in here, a salon, no fancy thermal suites or anything like that. They do have sauna and steam rooms in the spa, though. Just on the opposite side of the spa is the aerobics and fitness center where guests can work out or take a class. They actually have a class schedule that is posted in the fitness center on the very first day of the cruise. And some of them did have an added fee, but if you're into the different classes, check out that schedule and the fees. All the way forward is a place on the ship that's been there since inception, but it was called the Outrigger Lounge. Now it's called the Spinnaker. This place is probably comparable to... Well, it's an observation lounge. There's 270-degree sweeping views. It's actually really beautiful up here. They do hold a couple of classes up here during the day. I shouldn't say classes, maybe presentations. And if you just want to chill, you can come up here for a drink. There is a bar up here. Sometimes it might get interrupted with a shopping presentation or something, but there are bar servers up here as well and a piano. At nighttime, just a really cool, loungy type area. The last and final deck on Norwegian Sky is deck 12. All the way forward is an open-air lounge area with a pool and a hot tub. They call this pool up here a kids' pool, I'm assuming because of the size, but there were no kids in it during my sailing. There were all adults in it, also in the hot tub as well. Champs Bar is a place that you can go to smoke outside. It's also a bar overlooking the pool deck down onto deck 11 from right here. You'll also find outside activities on this deck, like a basketball court that overlooks the pool. On the port side, there's a shuffleboard game, and on the starboard side, you'll find a driving range for you golfers. Now, there are two more specialty restaurants located up here on deck 12 in the very back, though. So you have Cagney's. That's the steakhouse. It's an a la carte restaurant that's on the starboard side. And if you're going here to eat, you might want to have the dining perk. Otherwise, it'll set you back around $80 per person. Norwegian is really good with their value proposition, too, by the way, because I got a vodka soda at Cagney's, and it was $16. So if you're a drink person or a drink package person, you may want to pick that as a perk as well. I only had one perk on my sailing, so I did the dining package. That being said, their porterhouse steak and 7-layer chocolate dessert were both amazing. Now, opposite of Cagney's is the Sushi restaurant. This is also an a la carte venue, gets rave reviews as well. I didn't have a chance to eat here because folks were always at the sushi bar when it was open. A lot of people is always a sign of good food. And there's also a lounge area behind the sushi bar where you can kind of sit and have a late night drink or actually any time during the day. The place was always open. And then just outside of the sushi restaurant and Cagney's, there's an open terrace area with some tables and a good place to watch sail away. And that'll do it of our tour of Norwegian Sky. My name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of Cruise Radio and the daily Cruise Radio News podcast. You can find both of those where you listen to your favorite podcast. Just search Cruise Radio or Cruise Radio News. If you like these videos and you want to see more, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. You're the reason why I do make these videos. This was my first time sailing Norwegian Sky in 7 years, and I was really impressed with the renovations because really it was a rust bucket when I sailed it back in 2012, so I'm happy to see that it had a much-deserved makeover. What do you think of Norwegian Sky? Have you sailed her before? Let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching.